Now the last presentation of this morning, Josep Maria Llop, Tornet of the University of Lleida and also UNESCO Chair in Intermediate Cities. Josep Maria Llop, Tornet is an architect and city planner. It has worked at the Escuela Técnica Superior de Arquitectura de Barcelona and currently is professor at the University of Lleida. He has worked as director and coordinator of urbanism of Barcelona for several years, director of urban planning and environment of Lleida, is president of the Agrupación de los Arquitectos City Planners and of Catalunya, correct? Is, as I said, UNESCO chair in intermediate cities in Spain. So he has the floor now, and the title of his presentation is Urban Planning as a Recognition and Implementation of the Right to the City. You have the floor, please.
Grazie tante e buongiorno a tutti. Thank you so much. My second speech is for you. I say I give your comprehension because I will give you my sincerity. It's the first day that I use English in one university. I use Globish in different countries of the world, but not English. Pardon if my English is not regular. I will try to be clear and communicate. This is the challenge. Mm-hmm. When you are listening, speak about rights, and we are listening and speak about good administration and the local level to confirm the capacity of the populations to have rights, why not we can choose one new step more close with all the populations in the cities of the world, call it right to the plan. This is my proposal. We can improve the capacity of the people to be actors, not only to be participants in the planning, to be actors of the planning. And it means inclusive urbanism. I will try to explain this. I will try to explain this with examples. It's a long presentation, but I use short time because during the images of courses, I use a speed screen for not use the minutes time. We were before UNESCO chair, and it work of friends, architects, but the other professionals of the city, that we built knowledge about intermediary cities in the world with a voluntary work in network. Many, many people. If I imagine Argentina, I can say Cristina in Neuquén. If I imagine Agadez in Niger, I can say Mamoudou and the others. Lucknow in India, etc. We build knowledge in network and during the time that we see in the Habitat 2 summit, there is not a clear view of not the big cities, this is easy. The other kind of cities. The cities that they are medium sized, but it depends of the region, urban region, what is medium sized in China or in Catalonia. But the cities are conscious to be intermediary. Be between, go between, together. And this offer and new images of the urbanization in the world, and I will present our works in this line. And immediately I go to the second step and I propose we use a methodology of planning for to make planning with the population very easy to do for improve the condition of the population, sovereignty, empowerment. And this is the challenge. We, of course, publish in the last years books in different international languages with the help of, we work always in cooperation, of course, UNESCO help us in translation, but the others, publications, but one second level of cooperation, of course, UNESCO, of course, ONU Habitat, UN Habitat, the agency of the urbanization of the world, and of also with these images, United Cities local governments. For example, they have a charter for the right to the city. We are permanent workers with United Cities. I say only United Cities. This is documents of guide for the new policies in local level of this kind of intermediary cities. Intermediary cities, not big, not small, it depends in every region, but we will see the number of cities in the world because, as another book with this organization, because we applied and we advanced and we applied the research for speak with in international meetings, but also in local level with a general view of the world. Our more specific research is the first time in the world that exists the census of all the cities with more 50,000 inhabitants. There is not existing this research. We make the research with United Cities for Habitat 2, October 2016. Perhaps it's not easy to look at left part of the screen. I understand you cannot see all of the cities, but I offer you the information. In the world, in October 2016, there are near, because change the population, near 503 cities with more 1 million people, with 41%, a little more 41% of the urban population. But there are 8,923 cities between 1 million and 50,000, with 36% of the population. And the more small cities, there is not one study, international one, but there are hypotheses that there are near 150,000 urban nucleums with more of 10,000 inhabitants. This is the main reality of urbanization in the world. The people, the majority, live not in big cities, live in this kind of cities, but these cities are also territories because they are linked always with territories, rural population linked with cities. For example, if we see one continent like Africa, it's very different images if we only show is the big ones. But if we see this idea of connecting cities with territories, look the back images with light. This is light of the territories of the world linked with cities of 50,000 or more inhabitants. Different Africa, you can see Africa very different. Remember. In Africa, there are only 56 cities with more 1 million, 174 million people living, but 1,154 cities, intermediary scale, with more urban population. And remember, and the rural inhabitants linked every day with the city. Our international studies in this network of 176 cities in the world, we have the experience. It's normal that for one urban habitant, there are 1.5 rural using every day the city. Imagine the importance of the dimension rural, urban-rural of this kind of cities intermediate in the world. 10,000 inhabitants, Mediterranean area. I am proposing you a new paradigm, but I want to enter inside of the dimension of this kind of cities, and I speak a little about topology. The forms, the urban forms, that they don't change in the very heavy transformation process in the cities of the world. What are the characteristics, topologics, that it permits a methodology of planning for combined with the population and increase the presence of the population like actors in these cities? The right to the plan as the basis of the right to the city, because the plan makes the form of the space of life of the population. One city, second point, well, we are this year, of course, 70 years of the Human Rights Declaration, but 50 years after that Henri Lefebvre says right to the city. Today I say right to the plan. Connect with me, because I am very pleasured to offer you this idea. And this methodology of work, it's free software. I offer for all, for the universities, for the cities. Third point, the city without a plan favors the few who have power. For a city without plan generates inequality. Five, the right of the plan considers actions plans, not control plans. We must to change, we, the professionals of planning, we change the style of conception of technocratic idea. No, we need to use the plan like tool of development with the population, not for the population. And the base plan paradigm requires a new criteria for urban planning. Linked with the Sustainable Development Goals, of course. And what is this idea? I speak a little about the dimension of a number of these kind of cities in the world. I speak about the concepts, generic ones, but I now apply a little, not with extremely intensive, we are not in a planning conference, but what is base plan? Base plan is a base plan, basic one, not mandatory in the countries, because in different countries there are a national or local culture of planning. They must to use their culture of planning, but they can use this methodology for have a basic components of the future of the space of life of the city. Five physical components. These five physical components comes to the tradition of urbanistic style. And one strategic of development component, the basic projects that we need in 10 years. But make these two different styles of planning together. Integrate these two methodologies of planning. Okay? Second comment. Why this style of planning that they want to care the conditions of the urban form of these majority cities in the world can use the topologic conditions of this kind of cities linked with the human rights and the human life in the cities. If you see the images, you have at left the promedium, the medio, no? Dimensions of 90 cities in the world, intermediate one. You see one circle with a radium of 4 kilometers. This is a promedium of studies. This circle, it's a very simple methodology for combined with the others in China, in Africa, etc. The dimension of the space that include inside the 70% of the urban population. It's easy to combine in different languages, draw this circle. And when you draw this circle, and this is the promedium of 19 cities, you understand two things. One very classical in planning, density. But the other, more important, is distance. 4 kilometers is 1 hour. Many population can use walking the city. And this is very human condition, because perhaps we don't have bicycles, perhaps we don't have moto, perhaps we don't have cars. We need to care this physical dimension because it's a endogenous resources in the cities majority in the world. How we can use this topology, because this topology not change except if the cities grow very speed and arrive for more 1 million. At right part, there are in this moment, in this network that I presented in the second slide, 6 cities, big ones, that they want to study the cities with us in comparative dimension because they are not so much big, for example, Beirut, or for example, Montevideo. They are not big cities like today. The 6 cities at right are not the big metropolis or megalopolis of the world. Of course, in this case, the radio of this space is not 10. In these 6 cities, it's 10. 10 is 2.5 distant more than 4. Okay? But the question is not the distance only, the surface. Because this surface, it's P 16, and the right part, the surface is 100 pi. When we have a new form of the cities with big dimension, change completely the short distance of life of the population and increase quadratic the surface of this city. Increase the needs of infrastructuring services, and the big cities need and use more public budget than the others. And also has more private investment, because there are an economy of agglomeration. Easy to combine with consumption style. The big cities are good scenarios for a capitalism use of the city. The intermediate, there are good scenarios for a more good conditions of life. Bueno, in another moment, I can speak also in economic dimensions of this different topology, but it's not the moment. The time. This is one example of base plan. At left part, 5 physical components, urbanistic style. At right part, strategic of development components with the project, basic projects for the next 10 years. In this moment, I think I go speed because how we use this methodology in cooperation with Habitat, Agency of United Nations, of course with UNESCO, but United Cities local governments, but also universities or local governments in the world. You will see, with my speed use the images, courses in different countries of the world and different levels of cooperation. I only put a phrase for signal the style of this cooperation. During the last 6 years, the UNESCO chair with these international and local actors make 38 courses of base plan methodology in different parts of the world. They represent the presence of 1,445 professionals of teachers, and the minority are students of master of the last courses of not the first courses. You imagine the capacity of communicate, and the middle part of these courses in green in the screen are in Africa. I take the moment of the speech. International level, for example, write part our article for the inclusive urbanist inclusive cities of the UNESCO, and write part Harare, Zimbabwe. You need a UNHABITAT organization choice two examples of this methodology in left part, international guidelines or urban and territorial planning. We are experts for habitat and choice, I say, two examples. One city, one poor city using this methodology, Lichinga, Mozambique, close to Tanzania border. And the other is one regional government, the governor, Santa Fe, Argentina, use this methodology for understand in the local level what are the more important projects that they need. National level with the ministers of one country, Ecuador. In every courses, many local authorities. In the courses are, for example, one mayor or three local techniques of this administration, teachers, locals, always. I say another question very important. In these courses, I am not the teacher because they are the experts of the cities. And every student make Ecuador urban system, Esmeraldas, one city, every student make a base plan in these courses. 3 days only, it's very low cost, very easy to combine, national level. In some cases, helping with this methodology for the reconstruction of tremblement de terre, earthquake April 2016 in Manabí, in the coast of Ecuador, using this methodology for help this situation. Regional level, one governor used this methodology for understand the local needs of their municipalities to improve the urban, the policy of investment of the local level. For example, Abidjan, the group of architects in Abidjan, they chose two spaces for improve with this methodology the life. All space of the city of Abidjan, but also back the right part, one neighborhood close to the sea. Education in Africa, many courses, for example, with workshops, components of the plan. Extension land, it's a very important international problem. Many cities, they don't have plans and they increase the urban population every day. And we are very inconscientes because it's a real problem every day in many countries, in many cities in the world. This population arrive at the city, don't have land for to put the houses, and enter in the informal or illegal conditions. Why not choice and care the fair question, land for the population? I am European, but I don't say urbanized land, no. Land to put the things that they have. Not urbanization land. Sustainability, protection of the landscape, of the main elements of the natural spaces of the city. Mobility and services result with actions, the junctions, that they are difficulty on the border. Sí, no problem. Compactness, care, the position of the population in this city with methodology of understand the topology of the distance in the city. And one something not very complicated, the opposite sense, regulation improving, upgrading, regulation upgrading transform. It means different responsibilities for the local authority for this action of collaboration with the population. And projects, choose the projects for the next 10 years. This is the methodology. The intermediate scale offer advantages for to care the space of life of many inhabitants in the world. This represents also economic advantages for this population. One example final of this course, utilizing also system informatic geography, there is a platform for to see the methodology and the examples. Another level, someone thesis, doctoral thesis of urbanization in some cities can guide a more quality of planning. This thesis is, for example, one student of Trento University in rural cities in Mozambique. When you understand the population identity, use a circle around the tree for life and a circle around the water, you cannot design the plan with a rational drought. You need to care the water and use the connections spaces existing in the city. And this is one base plan with more respect for the conditions of life of the population. Two examples that we work directly with the municipality and the population. One, a small city, less 50,000, but with a more important center of studies from against malaria, Manisa in Mozambique. The team of work, they chose this list of projects, checklist of projects. It's a junction of ferroviary junction. And this is, for me, more loved example, because one poor city, Lichinga in the north, close to Tanzania border, Mozambique, says to the United Cities local government and habitat, we need a plan, we need a plan. We increase every day the population. In 10 years, the city, today 170,000 inhabitants, in 10 years, arrive more than 60,000 inhabitants in the city. We need a plan, we need a plan. And we combine, we pay the fly, you pay the hotel. Ah, we have only money for 3 nights. Okay, in 3 nights we make a plan with you. And see, I don't speak. I love very much this example. It's the first one in a local city. It's not easy, I try to explain exactly for Olga, to combine with women. But there is one in this team. In Manisa, there is another topographer. One city, poor city, the unique avenue, pavement in the city. At right, the general secretary of the Association of Municipalities in Mozambique. At left part, Monse, my friend, she was Architect Sans border, and she comes to help me in this. And what is our style? We don't invent professor. No? What is the start of this methodology? Your work, your job, your work. You have a strategic plan, yes? 10 projects. Okay, we chose these projects and we start to combine what is the physical urbanist dimension and the strategic one. 8 in the final, 8 are important in 10 years. The leaders of the community, these people are the very leaders of the community, explaining about the plan. And this is the result, and this is the team, except Monse, she is taking the photography. Final, I finalize. Okay. We are clear in this position. This style of planning change not only the capacity of the population to be actors in the development, right to the plan, right to be protagonists of the development of the city. This methodology changes also the technocratic ideas of the planning and change the model of planification using the advantages of the typology of intermediate scale of the urbanization in the world. It's a free software. If someone of this room won't use this methodology, no problem. Thank you for your attention.